Hello, and welcome to Craig Explains Stuff. I'm Craig, and today we're going to be talking about the AI singularity. Now, the AI singularity is the point at which computer artificial intelligence is supposed to surpass human intelligence, and many futurists believe that this will happen within the next 10 to 25 years. The problem with this analysis is that I don't think data processing is actually a particularly good criteria for intelligence. If we use that as our criteria, then I do agree that it will probably surpass humans within the next 10 to 25 years. And in fact, computer AI can already process and analyze certain types of data way faster and better than humans can currently. But the problem with that is that data processing is actually not generally considered by humans anyway as an intelligence test. Intelligence is much more complicated than that. So I'm going to explain the ways in which artificial intelligence is actually still sort of dumb and how that's actually creating problems and how we don't need to worry about artificial intelligence surpassing human intelligence anytime soon, regardless of whether or not they can process data faster. So my very first example of how AIs aren't really that good at analyzing data, I'm going to talk about photo recognition. Now, photo recognition is a common task that we give to artificial intelligence because we want them to be able to analyze photos very quickly and tell what the photo is of. Now, in this particular case, we have a photo of a cow in a field. And what you would do to get an AI to identify this as a photo of a cow is you would create a training algorithm, such as a neural network, and then you expose the training algorithm to thousands of pictures of cows in fields and cows not in fields, and you label them so that the AI can look at these photos, it can analyze the photos, and it can adjust its neural network so that it can identify cow photos from not cow photos. Now, the problem with this is that we're not totally sure how the neural network is going to decide whether or not the subject of a photo is a cow. It could look at the picture in its entirety and say, well, here's a cow, it's in a field, it's a pretty bright day, so that's how I know it's a cow. So if you show it a photo such as this one of a cow in an office, it's not going to be able to identify this as a photo of a cow because the field is not there. So it messes up its algorithm for identifying what a cow is. And please note that this particular task is a task that a three-year-old can pass. If you show a three-year-old a bunch of pictures of cows and go, this is what a cow is, and then show it a picture of a cow in an office, a three-year-old child can still realize that this is a photo of a cow. So this advanced AI system fails at a task that a very small human child can easily do. Now, you can retrain the neural network so that instead of it identifying the field, it only identifies features of the cow. And in this case, for example, let's say it identifies the blotchy black and white pattern as indicative that there's a cow in the photo. And in that case, it will still have problems because there are other photos that can contain this pattern that aren't pictures of cows. And in this particular case, I picked a model wearing sports leggings with the cow print, but it could also mess up with photos of a Dalmatian. It can mess up in a whole lot of different ways. And again, this is a task that a three-year-old can pass. So you might be thinking to yourself, well, so what? It's not particularly good at this photo recognition task. What's the big deal? The problem is that AI is starting to integrate more and more with daily life. And the people who are selling these AI programs to people are misrepresenting how well these AIs can work. And it's creating a lot of real-world problems for people. For example, this is a photograph of Niger Parks, who is accused of shoplifting candy and then trying to hit a police officer with a car in New Jersey. And the police identified Mr. Parks using AI facial recognition software. Now, the problem here is that in actuality, Mr. Parks was 30 miles away at the time of the incident. But the police relied on the AI identification and arrested Mr. Parks, who spent 10 days in jail and had to spend around $5,000 to defend himself, and it took him roughly 9 months before he finally got the case dismissed. Now, obviously, relying on AI facial recognition software that does not work will cause a great deal of undue false arrests. And in fact, Mr. Parks is suing the city and police for false arrests. But this isn't actually the worst example of AIs that can go wrong. Another particularly bad example is medical AI software. Medical AI software is actually used a great deal for screening patients for enrollment in programs. Now, in the case I'm going to talk about, the AI screening was meant to identify patients who would benefit from an intensive care management program. But the AI messed up quite badly in that it flagged white patients for enrollment at a much lower threshold of interest of illness than black patients, which meant black patients were not qualifying, even though healthier white patients were qualifying. And the problem with this is these sorts of programs and screening tools are actually widespread throughout the country, and these algorithms are making health decisions for approximately 200 million Americans every year. And if there's racial bias put into the software because of inadequate training, this will go all across the country and create all sorts of problems throughout this entire industry, and people will not get health care that they perhaps need. And you might think, wow, not getting proper health care and false arrests, these are very bad examples. But there's actually a worse example. This is a Uber vehicle that was outfitted with an autonomous mode, so it had an AI driver. Now, this particular Uber vehicle did not identify a pedestrian named Elaine Herzberg, who was in the road walking her bicycle. And since the AI did not identify her as a pedestrian at all, it did not attempt to slow down, and it hit Miss Herzberg at 40 miles an hour, killing her. So these sorts of programs are really dangerous if they're being promoted as being much smarter than they are. And that is what's happening. There's a great deal of people who believe AI is smart because people keep telling them AI processes data and analyzes data much faster than a human can, so it's smarter than a human. But they're actually not smarter than humans at all, and it's creating very dangerous situations out in the real world. And so not only do we not need to worry about AI surpassing human intelligence, what we really need to worry about is AI being promoted as intelligent when it is not. So that is my explanation of AI, the AI singularity. It's not a thing we need to worry about. It's not being judged even remotely appropriately. And artificial intelligence is, in reality, quite a long way from even meeting human intelligence standards. This has been Craig for Craig Explains Stuff. If you like this video, please hit like and please hit subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Thank you very much.